things that we were against. And I've noticed more and more of these things have, we've gotten so used to it and it's so common, we don't hear as many complaints about them anymore. For example, the DRM.
Yeah, it used to be hell no. Now it's just like, eh.
It's almost installed on the systems themselves now. I mean, both PS4 and Xbox One, and stuff like Steam and Origin and everybody else is doing stuff similar. Basically, they are DRM machines because they're always online, which is the other thing that almost connects that together. Those are two things people really, really hated, and now it's the norm.
It's starting to become... They're starting to do it in acceptable ways.
The thing is that you can be connected online with your Xbox, but you don't have to actually play the video game online. You can set it up so that you can play the game even if your system has no connection, which is what they weren't going to do originally, and everybody was horribly against that, and they got panned for it, so they double backed on it and were like, okay, well, never mind, you can play your game offline. Everybody was like, okay, cool.
Yeah, do what we want, and we, what the f*** was that? Oh, it's the stupid Farmville. Stupid Farmville crap.
We cut Grover in the act.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, that's the major thing that I think that you don't see us complain so much because, I mean, most people say, you know, you hear me talking stuff that we're going to go beat the hell out of the developer or something, but that's hardly ever what happens. I don't think I've seen a case of a developer being insulted, which if that ever happened, I would be highly ashamed of everybody in the gaming community. We can kill each other, but not the developers, okay? That's the rules.
That's definitely.
It's kind of a hot topic right now.
But
still?
Oh, yes. It's worse than ever.
Yeah, usually we work with the developers. Like, always online. If they do it in a way that it doesn't shove it down our damn throats, we're like, sure, no problem. Just as like with everything else. But when you do something like with SimCity, for example, obviously we're going to be very pissed off, especially when you did it intentionally to force it down our throats.
The anti-piracy stuff off of it. There's even a lot of companies that's even said it's not working. What's the point?
Yeah.
I mean, the Sims 4 just came out, and it was famous for having the little pixelized thing if somebody tried to download the copy of it. When any character would go into one of those modes where they would censor the nudity of it, it would censor the entirety of the game, and supposedly you weren't able to fix that. That was fixed within hours. You cannot stop the anti-piracy stuff.
Pirates, so everybody with the pirated version of the game had a fixed version. Players that legitimately bought it are still having that problem.
They're still getting glitched.
Yeah.
Go EA.
So basically, you get punished for buying a game.
And that is, that's why people are against that.
Mm-hmm.
Because all it really does do is create a hassle for the people that really do pay for it. And you're never going to stop the pirates themselves, so...
Push this right along. There's also casual games, which used to be absolutely hated by the hardcore community, and I know it still is by a lot of people, but I think we've kind of accepted it more. Partly because we're seeing a lot more kind of casual games seeping into the hardcore. How many times have you seen little mini-games of puzzles and stuff like the World of Warcraft nod to Plants vs. Zombies and stuff like that? Like that. There's nothing wrong with it.
No, there's nothing wrong with it at all.
It's a different style of game.
And I've actually seen a trend that some people may not notice yet. You're playing a game, like you're playing your main game, and then you're playing another little game, usually. For me, I would be playing Warlock, and then I would drop out of Warlock, and Screw is banished. And I mean, I know some people are just like, huh, you're playing two games at the same time. But yeah, and that's starting to happen now, too.
Especially with the more casual games, because like the Farmville and stuff, like Tynan, you can keep it on the background, play something else, and you're basically playing two games at the same time.
Here's a way better example. When I was playing Legion of Legends, I always had Field Runners in the background. Between battles, I would jump into Field Runners and play rounds until the next battle started.
Because there's a lot of waiting in the lobbies.
Oh, yeah. Tons of waiting.
Well, here's a thought, too. When was the last time you actually bought a game and you took it home and you played nothing but that game until it was finished?
That's true.
I can't even imagine doing that anymore because they don't hold my attention like that. I'm always flitting back and forth between games.
Gamers have gotten a little spoiled in that regard, I have to admit.
Yeah, I mean, there's so many coming out all the time that it's hard to play one and only one.
Mm-hmm.
I think the last game I did that for was Fallout.
The original?
Fallout 3.
Oh.
I will say that as for the indie market, I actually did play all the way through Shovel Knight in just a couple of nights, but that was a short game. I did that with Skies of Arcadia back when it came out on GameCube, which wasn't an awful long time. Okay, it was kind of a long time ago. But anyways, when it came out on GameCube, I went home and I played nothing but Skies of Arcadia. And if that game were to come out today, or a game like it that I enjoyed just as much, I still wouldn't be able to sit there and play nothing but that game until it was finished.
your fans getting in your microphone again.
Same. It takes a lot longer for me to get into a game like where I'll play it 14 hours straight, which I can't do that anymore. I used to be able to, but that's for younger gamers now. I can't deal with that anymore.
I admit that I was pretty heavy in Minecraft, but I cannot think of anything before that maybe the original Disgaea. That would be the next closest that I can really think that I just sunk constant time into. But Minecraft ate me alive.
You guys were doing Disgaea when I was doing Tactics. I'll head to Tactics. So it was basically, about the same thing.
I got into that with Tactics too, but that was several years before then. Speaking of Minecraft, that's kind of a merge of casual games and hardcore games, because it can be considered either.
Yeah, you do Feed the Beast for the hardcore versions of it, or even just the normal game itself. Yeah,
that game can get hard by itself.
I just don't like the terminology.
There you go. Let's remove labels.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. Because what is hardcore? I mean, is it... People play Farmville all day. That's hardcore to them.
People in Banish all the time talk about hardcore. Like, the game's hardcore. I'm just like, okay.
But
for some people, they're just like, it is hardcore. Because that game can be relentless to you if you don't know what you're doing.
I don't think it's so much about the difficulty so much as the majority of consoles are considered for gamers. They are not for people that just play games now and then. You buy a console to play video games on, even though they've tried to sell them off as like movie machines and everything else.
Yeah.
And then you've also got the PC into things, where most of what makes the PC market run up until MMOs kind of exploded was niche markets. You had the real-time strategy games. You had the sim games, both the simulator types and the more strategy-oriented types. And you had the people that were really good, really into the first-person shooters. So that's a very different market, including marketing strategy, than, say, the people that are playing Solitaire and Bejeweled. So there is a line between the hardcore and the casual that's really easy to see. But at the same time, we all are gamers, technically. So stop the hate!
When they start ragging on each other, it just seems like this is very pointless to me.
And since this is actually running longer than I intended to, I'll throw these last two on here because they're very similar to each other, is DLC and microtransactions.
Yeah.
And microtransactions actually leans more to those casual games we were just talking about. They're a little less so in the hardcore, but they're still there. They're still there.
Zynga is the god of that.
Yes.
And they're suffering for it because it wasn't the fact that they did it wrong, that they were doing it. No one cares about that because it's all over everywhere. It's the fact that they shoved it down your throat. If I want to support your game, I will. But don't do it for ridiculous reasons. Like, do you want to go a little faster or intentionally make something harder specifically for you? Like, well, you got to wait 19 years to do this. But if you pay us $2, you could do it now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there was a Star Trek game that's very similar to those Zynga-style games that was put on mobile. And the game itself wasn't bad, but it took so long to get the items you needed, and all of the stuff that you were doing took so much time you had to spend like 60 hours doing this before you could actually do the thing that you were trying to do in the first place, and the only way to actually get through the game was to spend literally hundreds of dollars on it. Free game, mind you, but...
Yeah, you go to do something, and then 19 hours later, or a couple of days later, you get done doing something, and you have to remember exactly why you were doing that in the first place.
Of course, that's actually part of the monster that is MMOs. They need to keep you playing for as long as possible, because if you get all powered up, then you're going to get bored. You have to have something to build through, which is part of my argument against them, but at the same time, there's people that love doing that kind of stuff, so more power to Mike.
I think, yeah.
And the DLC thing, I don't mind that, like we were talking about the Smash Brothers. If you have a game and you're wanting to keep it alive a little longer, add tracks to your racing game, add new maps to your first-person shooter, add new characters to your fighting games. What I think really ticked people off is how much of this stuff was ready or near ready at launch, and then they would sell it.
Yeah, they'd hold it just simply to release it later, which is bullshit.
It would feel like it was an incomplete game.
Well, it also just make you feel like you're just getting ripped off.
Yeah, Street Fighter Cross Tekken kind of hammered that point home that nobody wants to do that anymore. Come to find out that the majority of all those DLC characters were on the disc. There was just some parts missing where they couldn't get it finished in time. But that's not really an excuse. I'm sorry, guys.
It's an interesting fact that there's people I know that say they consider microtransactions in DLC to be the exact same thing.
In a way, it can be, because a lot of DLC and microtransactions are tightly wound around customizing characters.
Mm-hmm.
Like buying outfits or buying guns that look a little different or shoot a little different, that sort of thing. So
that's exactly it.
But yeah, I guess that was a... kind of a complicated topic to just try to throw in there and get some minor opinions on, but some small extra notes before we end. In light of the Kickstarter project failures that have been coming quite rampant lately, and especially since they're becoming controversial about what the people that are running the projects are doing when they fail, Kickstarter has actually redesigned the language of their agreement to ensure that the backers actually have a right to legal action if the project runners cannot show that they responsibly used its resources, as well as a reasonable reason why they couldn't complete their promised projections.
That is a fantastic thing to hear.
So in other words, basically a little bit of transparency. Not even a whole lot, but a little bit. You know, kind of government transparency.
No, you cannot kickstart trying to build the Enterprise.
Was that ever a thing?
I wouldn't be surprised.
No, I could just see somebody trying it, and they'd get all this money, and be like, well, I couldn't do it, and you guys screwed.
We needed Scotty, man.
I mean that you can't put a Kickstarter on for potato salad. It's still perfectly fine, which as far as I know, he did, and he did exactly what he was supposed to do.
Yep.
And he paid quite a bit of damn taxes, I heard, too.
Wouldn't be surprised. That was a lot of money all at once.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
And also, NVIDIA unveiled their new GTX 980 and GTX 970 Maxwell graphics cards. So, like, spending quite a bit of change to keep up with the latest. Here's the latest once again. I haven't actually seen the specs on them yet. So, but yeah, follow us on Twitter, and you can contact us with email at printcast@gmail.com. I almost wonder if I should bother telling people to contact us at Twitter, because we don't pay much attention to it anymore. I'll be honest. I've been really bad with Twitter.
Thing for an entire year. No one said a damn thing, so.
No.
Guys.
But we don't really do anything either.
Guys, we have a Twitter?
I've heard of this.
Well, do that tweet thing. No.
I probably use it more often, but I don't know. I don't know what my excuse is. I probably have a dozen of them. Especially lately, I'm trying to avoid becoming basically an activist at this point. I'm getting really tired of some of the stuff that's going on in the world right now. But I'm trying to keep separated from it, because who'd listen to me anyway?
Please, no Johns. It's Smash Timber for Nintendo. It's Smash Super Smash Brothers, no Johns. You watch all of these tournaments and you do not know what no Johns means.
Apparently not.
Oh my gosh. So there's like this legend, which apparently is true according to some people. I don't know, because I wasn't really part of the whole scene. I'm still really not, but I do actually kind of watch it now. There was a guy that would show up to tournaments and his name was John. And every time he lost, he had an excuse. Oh, my hands were sweaty, so I couldn't operate the remote correctly. It was just an excuse.
I know.
He had a dumb excuse for every loss. And so the saying no Johns kind of become a thing. So even Reggie at the Invitational this year actually said, please, no Johns. So,
yeah, I haven't heard that one myself, yeah.
I'm really surprised with how into the fighting scene you are that you haven't heard of it.
Not as much as I have been. Once again, that time just keeps flying away somewhere.
But yeah, so you were saying you don't know what your excuse is. You probably have a dozen of them, and I said no Johns.
I got you.
And then there were
the controller was slippery. I couldn't Twitter. There you go.
The keyboard thing had some missing functionality.
There's not enough keys.
Which one is the V button? I can't type my words correctly. These are just single letters. Where are my words?
I only have L and O. What possibly can I do with that? Anyway.
Lol.
I'm just Nintendo.
Okay, well, we've wasted you guys' time long enough. We'll see you all next time.
See you next time.
See you next time.